Hello YouTube, you may remember this stove. This is my last stove project that I did, and I used it during last winter, and I managed to save some wood, and I burned something like 3 to 4 cubic meters of wood in a family house. It is pretty okay. Now, the stove, as you can see, this is the combustion chamber. You can see the other video to see the details, and I used here a crate like 5 centimeters tall, and then I stuck the wood, and within 12 hours all the space below the crate would be filled with ashes. I had to stop the combustion of the stove, remove the ashes, a very uncomfortable arrangement. And so what I decided is that I bought this piece of steel. This is the bottom. I'm going to use this. I want to weld this here underneath the stove to put here a tray that will work as an ashtray, and they will give me already a few days that I can burn wood without to fill it up. Now, the bottom, I'm going to put I'm going to install this at the bottom here of this plate. I'm going to install this these casters. They are rated for 60 kilograms, I suppose, each one of them. And let me show you what happened to the stove during this past one season burning. Okay, here there is the accumulation of this let's call it powder that comes from the combustion. It deposits here on the walls. Okay, so no creosote, and okay, let's start cutting and building. If this is the stove laying down and this is the bottom, the idea is to come here and cut the bottom of this bit over here of plate and remove it, and then assemble here this bent plate, okay, to work as an ashtray. Now, probably I'm just going to cut 2 bits, leaving here a bit of steel, so with the heat the walls of the stove are not going to bend outwards. Okay, so only this bit here and this here will be removed, and I'll leave this one here in the middle. The stove is secured here with the rope to the vise and to the bench. The markings are done. Let's start chopping here with a super sophisticated tool. As you can see, the bottom of the stove is cut. I already also cut here the indentations I need to cut to install here the compartment that is going to work as the ashtray. Okay, so now it is a question of fine tuning here the contact points and weld these parts one to the other, and square everything right, and let's see how it comes out. You can see that the plate, okay, is not sitting perfectly here. There are some gaps in some places, some gaps over here, a few more gaps. Okay, and I'll have to come here where there are bits of welding beads and so on that I need to grind it with angle grinder to so that this bottom part for the ashtray is going to fit a line and square. Finally, you can see the stove is completely square with the table. The table is completely flat, and I'd like to show you how much metal I had to remove over here. It is like something like 5 to 6 millimeters. Okay, even though I tried to weld when I built the stove, tried to weld this air entrance at the same level as this air entrance, things were not quite square. This is what happens when we make everything by hand, without a jig and without machines, and some mistakes arrive from that. First of all, the square pipe that I used, it's not completely square, this is arched more or less each side, and then I cut over here to include the secondary air entrances. And but now, finally, after 5 or 6 times picking up the 90 kilos of the stove and setting it on the plate, finally everything is square. Now it's time to spot weld. Okay, the plate that makes the walls of the ash compartment is already tack welded, and now it's time to weld the bottom. Because I forgot to make some chamfers here to weld here the bottom to the walls, I decided to put here bits of 2 millimeter wire just to open a small gap. Okay, so it's to be welded. In order to give a bit more stability here to the stove, the ash chamber for the ashtray is a bit too short, is a bit shorter than the total length of the stove, and most of the weight is located here in the in this area. Okay, so I'm going to extend a bit the base. I have this bit of plate over here. I'm using just the washers for space. I'm going to lay here a bead, and I'm going to reinforce this place with a 10 by 10 millimeter stock, square stock that I have. Like make triangular structures, like from here to here, from here to here. And underneath I'll place the caster. Okay, the bits of stock of 10 by 10 millimeters are welded into place here to reinforce this area. Air can flow freely into here now, and now it's time to build a frame for the door that is going to seal here the ash compartment entrance. Okay, and this is made out of stock 20 millimeters by 8 millimeters. The door will be 6 millimeters a plate. I secure the frame over here to the top of the table with C clamps, and here in the corner, because I have no other possibility, I use just some bits of steel to make some weight. I chamfer here the contact points. Now let's go weld it and make the frame. The frame is tack welded into place. Okay, and now it is time to close this gap, and there is a similar gap on the other side. Now I made here a paper template, and well, you have to believe me that this will fit over here, and I'm going to cut a bit of metal from to place here, and let's start. Now this gap is closed. Let's go for and close the other one. The stove is on the floor, So now it's time to start welding all these seams. So here it will be tight and the air will not come in. So let's start welding. Since we cut here this bit of the stove to allow ashes then to fall from here to the ash compartment, and I left here this bit of bottom, let's call it, just to avoid the stove to open with the heat. I think that I'm going to, I have here these four beads that I'm going to put one bit over here, another bit over there back there, and two more beads here on this side, just to reinforce a little bit. It's better to be safe than sorry, and to avoid the stove at the bottom to open with the heat. I decided that I want to build a dolly to be to sit the stove on top of it. So I don't have the materials that I want, but I have all sorts of mild steel stock over here. So this is clear that I'm going to cut a little bit to make the base where I'm going to screw the casters. This is most probably part of the frame that is going to be connecting the casters, and I have also this flat stock, 40 by 4 millimeters, round stock 6 millimeters, and this is a square stock 12 by 12 millimeters. So let's see what is possible to build with this. So this is the basic idea for the dolly that I came up with. Here I have a bit of a square profile that is 40 by 20 millimeters, 3.25 millimeters thick walls. Here these over here are going to receive the casters, okay, and here I have flat stock here and here, and I'll probably put here the 6 millimeter round stock here crossing to give some rigidity. Let's see how it looks like. Now I came up with this basis, this structure for the dolly, and now need to weld this plate over here, 2 for the front, 3 for the rear, where the heaviest bit of the stove is going to be located, and so we can screw, we can bolt in here the caster. Before setting the door in place, welding the door in place, I just glued here this the gasket. Okay, let's see how it goes. The stove is ready. And see, these are, I didn't made the video of this bit here that I put this closing mechanism, but it is similar to this one seen in the previous video. This is the ash compartment, this is combustion chamber. If you manage to see, okay, you can see it more or less clearly. Compartment. Now I only need to build a tray or a box or whatever how you call it, okay, to put here in the ash compartment or in the ash chamber or whatever. The tray to contain the ashes, it will be made out of a zinc plated sheet. It is a very, very thin material. I don't know how thick this is. It looks to me like less than 0.5 millimeter. And here I made the markings already. I don't know if you can see it. Yeah, I can see it. Let's start cutting and bending. I'm building my tray, of course, with my this super sophisticated bending machine for a metal sheet. Okay, the stove is painted. Now I lit the stove to cure the paint. If you can see, no smoke, you know, burning. Looks like it is burning as usual with secondary combustion. Okay, this paint, while it is curing, it stinks terribly. This is the dolly that it is also over here on the stove to cure the paint before I install the casters. Okay, before I install here the casters, and so I'm not going to have bad smell and surprises at home when the paint is curing. Now I'm going to light this stove for several days outdoors, and for several hours each day, to be sure that I'm not going to bring any bad smells into the house. Okay, the stove is set at home. As you can see, it is painted. It was burning outdoors something like 12 to 15 hours. Here you can see the dolly, where the stove sits on the dolly with the casters. Now, let me show you details of the ashtray. The ashtray, ash compartment, ash box, ash pan, whatever you want to call it. Okay, here the wood burns and the ashes fall in here, inside the box. Okay, you can see it's pretty snug over here. The dimensions of the box is wider than the ash pan, so the ash compartment is not going to be dirty with ash. This is the door that closes snug here with this mechanism to close it. Now I intend to open this like once a month, so it's a very long time for it to fill up with ashes. Dimensions. This compartment, it has the width is useful width. It's 26 centimeters. By the height is like 21 or 20 centimeters height. And if we look here on the side, okay, I build this wall with a bit of plate. It is slightly taller. It is 30 centimeters from here to here. Okay, but of course the stove is up until down here, something like that. So now let's see how long it is. The total length is 52 centimeters, and we still have this bit of a tail over here where air gets in. So let's when I lit the stove outdoors to cure the paint, I managed to get here in this area to temperatures of 420 430 centigrade. Let's see how it performs and how the ash compartment will affect the overall performance of the stove. To see if there is any smoke coming out or something. So let's light the stove and see what happens. The stove is ready to be lit. Let's start. When the stove is hot and warm, I'll show you the temperature readings, and let's see if there is any smoke escaping the stove when we reload it. I lit the stove 5 minutes ago. Temperatures are not so high yet. The primary air is fully open. The damper is fully open. And secondary area is always open, so Let's see what happens when I open the stove. Reload some wood. You can listen to this. Rocket stove still. You can listen to the rumbling of the rocket stove. I'm using the wood that I have over here to light. It is pellets. I just break pellets. And I'm using citrus wood. And this is Mediterranean pine wood. And I have here also plum. Okay, let's let it burn and see how the secondary combustion will occur. 15 minutes since I lit the stove. Focus, 335 degrees. You will have to believe me. Since I lit the stove, 15 minutes, and 272 degrees. These are centigrades, okay? The damper. If you can see it, The damper is closed almost all the way, like three quarters. Okay, you can see here the very small gap for the primary air, and you can see the secondary burning occurring at the top of the stove. I don't know if you can see blue flames. Red and orange is red and orange. Yellow and orange is, are the colors that are more that you can see through this camera. But there are blue flames and purple, and it is burning very slow. During the experimentation I did outside, it seems that the ashtray or the ash compartment is making no negative influence in the overall performance of the stove. Now, the experiments that I did outdoors, one full load of wood could last between 1 and 1.5 hours. Wood like branches like this way, like 40-50 millimeters diameter. Okay, and if I put a solid block of wood in here, it lasted with flame more than 3 hours. And for more than 3 hours, the flame there was wood burning, and the hot coals were still burning for another, let's say, about after 4 hours. 4 hours at a fairly warm stove. Now, temperatures, I managed to get to 430-420 degrees in this area of the stove during the experimentation. Now, what is the temperature now? It reached already 320 here at the top. The top 337. So now it will be 100 more degrees centigrade. The stove is burning more or less for 40 minutes. I made one more reload of wood. You can see the combustion and how the secondary combustion is occurring. The air settings is more or less the same, and the damper set is more or less the same. So let's make some temperature readings here. 420. This is the hottest part of the stove that is exposed to the outside. Now here at the top, 350 more or less. Okay, here air intake, primary air intake 225, secondary intake 350 degrees, ash compartment, and then 85 degrees over here. Here 133 degrees, here the level of the wheels, 45 degrees, 41 degrees, 37 degrees back here. It is impossible to be here. Well, it seems that the ash compartment didn't make any, did not influence the overall performance of the stove, and there is no smoke coming out when you open the door. And thank you for watching.